What's going on, everyone? I'm back again with another video. I apologize. It's been at least 2 weeks since I've dropped a video. Thanksgiving break or Thanksgiving, I was up in my girlfriend's house in Detroit and spent the whole week there. And then I had to hop on a flight to go straight down to Miami for NFT Basel, Blockchain Week, Art Basel, the whole nine. So met a lot of different people in the industry. It was really cool. I'm working on a project as well. So it's kind of cool to bump heads with these developers, blockchain, you know, consultants. It's really cool group of people. So super thankful for that opportunity. While I was down there, I actually ran into someone who put me on to Koinos. Super cool layer one. Kind of reminds me of like what EOS was doing a while ago, but this is gonna streamline adoption for so many people. Reason being, they've got rid of the need to purchase your native token on a chain, such as buying Ethereum to pay for gas. It says right here, you know, in their title, Koinos is a blockchain with no fees. Well, ultimately, that's what they've done. So you hold KOIN, which is their native token, and it has a property called mana. It's like the old school understanding of like a video game. If you're playing Grand Theft Auto and you hold the sprint button for a long time, eventually he stops sprinting because you've used up the stamina or the energy. It takes a few seconds. You got to wait until it recovers. Same idea here. Instead of having to pay for gas, you have to wait for your tokens to regenerate gas. I think this is, you know, phenomenal because it stops people from just running up transactions on the blockchain and pulling resources to, you know, do useless things, or they're just swapping just to swap type of idea. So it makes it to say, well, you will no longer cause people to be at a detriment because you want to spend, you want to spend all the resources in the chain to do what you want to do. Well, now if you buy a certain amount of coins, it will, you know, you'll have enough resources to utilize for what you want to do, but you won't impact everyone else. So super cool. I got into the white paper I read. It explains mana right here. They want, like I said, they want free accounts, free transfers, and free smart contracts so everybody can utilize this. I see a lot of other chains getting bridged over, a lot of other tokens getting bridged over to this chain for the simple idea of no gas. That'll help a lot. I see a lot of businesses using this on their back end for everyday consumers who have no idea what's even going on with the blockchain or blockchain tech. Because that way they can pay for, you know, the gas, quote unquote. They can use their mana that's stored in tokens on their back end for users to interact on the front end. So that's very, very helpful for businesses to utilize as well. So yeah, I mean, also you just got to think in terms of investment, the KOIN, token KOIN is going to sustain its price, its value, because people need to hold this in order to have mana to interact with the chain. So you're not going to see this huge pump and dump just for people speculating. There's always going to be some investors that don't really care about the underlying protocol. They just care about profits. But I think this will be a chain that a lot of people will utilize in the future. So I'm really, really excited. I believe this is going to be pretty big. It kind of goes into detail here in this paragraph. I encourage you, man, get on here, go to koinos.io and look at their white paper. It explains in all detail. I've read through this entire thing. It's really cool. They explain the regeneration time period, how the tokens are locked and you can no longer use them until it has regenerated. Same concept. If you were to fail a transaction and now you're out of mana, you still have to wait. But at least you don't have to add more money to it. You know, it's a time lock concept. And I love the way that they've connected this to an everyday idea of something like mana or stamina, because everybody understands this. If you haven't played a video game, you just get the concept of you've gone too hard. You need to take a break, instead of saying, yeah, you've maxed everything out, but I'll charge you you know, more money if you want to go a little bit harder. It's like, it doesn't work like that. When you're out, you're out. So I think this is a better approach to blockchain as a service, is what a lot of people would say. Instead, this kind of opens up the door for everyone. Now, you know, developers can mint and practice, and this can become a legitimate chain that they can develop on without having to worry about a bunch of fees. And some people say, oh yeah, well, the test net and this, that, and a third. It's like, yeah, but still, once you actually get, you know, the test net ready to go and you're ready to launch, you still have to consider how many times you have to try this with the live environment and real users to get it right, and how much money am I going to lose, you know, running Ethereum transactions and smart contracts. A lot. I'll answer that question. A lot. It's just not even worth it in a lot of cases. So yeah, check this out. Give it a look. Still super, super cheap. It's like 80 cents right now. One of my mentors, he basically described it as buying Solana under $1. And I 1000% agree with him. As soon as I took the time to look through it, yeah, I was blown away. So yeah, this is just my focus for this particular video. Koinos, I mean, I personally think we found a gem super early. Their mainnet's gonna launch in Q1 2022. So everybody's screaming for bear market, yada, yada, yada. I personally think people won't care if it's a bear market if you just eliminated gas fees. So we'll see. And I mean, stay tuned on this. I would say follow their Telegram, Discord, go to the blog. Yeah, check out their whole deal. So yeah, I mean, even here, so they go into detail explaining about, you know, a layer zero concept behind what they're doing to be able to access all layer ones. So they kind of throw it all out there, you know, super, super, super in depth too. That's what I love. This white paper and this website, man, they did a great job describing everything. So there you go. Appreciate you guys watching another video. It's pretty short, just trying to explain, you know, what I found. And I also want to focus on things that are going to move this ecosystem forward. Everyone gets, you know, caught on just pump and dumps. I actually believe in cryptocurrencies and what they can do for people. So I'm going to share more of insights on how you can take your everyday life and move it somewhat on chain to eliminate some of the everyday inconveniences you have. Like right now, I have money trapped in my brokerage account that they won't allow me to remove because apparently I invested in metamaterials. Apparently it's still up for grabs, as in transferring from one company to the next. They're doing a merger, and it's just like, it's crazy, bro. Like, I should be able to access my money whenever I feel like it. And I think crypto as a whole is allowing people to do that. It's also introducing, I'm going to stop saying DeFi and start saying open finance, because there's nothing decentralized about this. There is still a protocol that we're putting money, we're trusting to kick us back yields and do it. We're trusting tech, but yes, there's still something. There's a trusted party. It's not peer to peer. But at the same time, this allows us to do what banks do, and it gives us way higher returns. So yeah, I'll speak more on that in a project I'm helping work on, Fuse, which is another full stack, or, you know, layer one blockchain that I've seen in development for a while now. And I think it's a really good project to get, you know, a lot of people onboarded. I mean, even their on-ramp has zero gas fees. So really cool. And I'll speak in more detail in the next video, but I appreciate you guys watching. Till next time.